This week for the Time Project Spotlight, I talked to Nicole Rideout.
So this year our project was titled The Antimicrobial Activity of Endophytes Isolated from Transylvania County's Brake Lift Plants. This summer I read some articles about antibacterial activity in freshwater sea sponges, and I really got interested in the topic of natural occurring antimicrobial compounds. And we went to Lower Barwello Falls in Gorges State Park and collected plant samples, and we isolated endophytes. So in the future, this could be used in the medical field. So the compounds we extracted could be used in medicine. The Time program definitely helps if you know you're interested in science, but allows you to feel out what types of science you would be interested in the future.
For this week's Club Spotlight, we talk about Project Unify. Project Unify is a club that meets in Miss Plum's room, and you meet with the kids and you play games and you get to know them, and it's really fun. I don't really have a specific job, but I make sure that I get to know every kid and have a friendship with them. The R Word campaign is a campaign to spread the word, to end the word, so to stop the usage of the R word. And they would meet in the cafeteria lobby and you would sign the pledge and get like a little sticker.
I am president of Project Unify. We meet on Tuesdays during I&E.
People join Project Unify.
They can email me and I'll put them on the list for Tuesday during I&E.
Hi, welcome back to EZPN. I'm Parker Grant and we're here with Luke Milligan. Welcome back to another episode, and this week we are going to be discussing about the upcoming sports events for next week.
That's right. We'll be talking to a member of the Brevard High School tennis team to see what they have to do to make this season great, just like they've had in the last couple of years. And next week we have the schedule for you if you want to go see some games. We've got men's golf meeting at, they have a meet at Hendersonville today, meet at Waynesville on Thursday. How about baseball, Parker?
Baseball is actually going up against Tuscola today at Franklin on Tuesday, and they have a home game against Smoky on Friday.
That's right. Softball does not have any games this week. However,
I know.
Women's soccer is playing at Chase today, and then Chase is coming to visit us on Wednesday, and then they have a meet or a game at Irwin on Friday.
And the track? They have a meet at Polk on Friday. And tennis, they have a home game, or a match, I should say, against East Henderson on Thursday.
That's right, Parker. And fortunately, Ma Long couldn't be with us today because he was polishing his gold medal. However, we have another gold medalist to talk to next week, the winner of the 100-meter or 200-meter speed skate, Stephen Bradbury of Australia, who won after being in dead last, and everyone else in his race fell over, and then he crossed the finish line in first place, so good for him.
Pure luck at its finest.
That's right. Well, that pretty much sums up this episode of the Sports Center. I'm Luke Milligan, and this is Parker Grant, and thanks, and we're signing off.
This week for Cooking Corner, we made Funfetti Cake Dip. First step is to put an entire box of Funfetti Cake Mix into a bowl. The next step is to combine it with one whole container of Cool Whip. After that, you'll mix it together. Your next step is to take plain yogurt and put it in as you see fit until it becomes kind of like an icing texture. After that, you want to taste it and see if you've put enough yogurt, and then top it with sprinkles and eat it.
Today on Medieval Minute, we have a half minute or 30 seconds to tell you everything you need to know about history. Fact number one, historians aren't very sure if Alexander the Great was a blonde or a brunette, but we do know he was a gay icon of his time. Fact number two, Christopher Columbus was fake as heck. Leif Erikson made it there first by around 600 years. Well, I mean, the natives made it there first, but no one really talks about that, so we'll move on. Fact number three, two thermonuclear bombs were dropped on North Carolina. And, well, it has nothing to do with North Korea, and it was in the 60s, and they didn't really go off, but I guess we're just lucky we don't have any mutants. Though, that's a different story for South Carolina. Thank you for your time here on Medieval Minute, where we have a half minute, or 30 seconds, to learn everything you need to know about history. Teddy Roosevelt rode on a moose, and I'm signing off. Thank you.
yeah, we need some action!